Hello, Taurus. Welcome to your 72 and you reading, where we are looking at what is taking place for your sign over the next 72 hours. You can watch this reading if you are a Taurus sun, moon, or rising Taurus on the house cusp. If you have your sun in the second house or Venus in Taurus, you can watch this reading. I'll also include if you have your Mercury or Jupiter in Taurus, feel free to tune in. Cross watchers are also welcome here. Just keep in mind, this is a general forecast and we're focusing on Taurus today. So I will be focusing on their energy, not the cross watcher, for example. Personal reading information is down below in the description box, including my website and scheduling page. It's also up in the right-hand corner. Just click that eye in the sky. That will take you to my scheduling page where you can book a reading at your convenience. And then for today, we're using two decks, The Oracle of Shadows and Light by Lucy Cavendish, artwork by Jasmine Beckett Griffith. That would be this deck right here. If you'd like more information, here is the QR code on the back. You can take a screenshot of that, scan it in, and perhaps get the guidebook and website contact information. For tarot cards today, we are using Tarot Familiars by Lisa Parker. The publisher is Fournier Publishing, and I do have, sorry, that sage was a little bit strong. We do have a website for you, for the Tarot Familiars deck. Right there, feel free to take a screenshot of that, and hopefully that helps someone out there. Those are also listed down below. I always put my tarot decks down below in the bottom of the description box. Other pertinent information would be down there as well, including my Groupon deal, where you can save up to 50% off my 30-minute live tarot readings. Donation information is down there. Yeah, so Taurus, you're the last sign in this series. That's the way Spirit wanted it to be, I guess, because I've been drawing my little zodiac signs out of the box, or out of the cauldron there. So let's see what energies are surrounding Taurus, what's coming towards Taurus, what can they expect, what is happening for the sign of Taurus. General messages. Next 72, Spirit, show me what is taking place for the sign of Taurus. Okay. We have Fairy of the Green World. The natural world needs you. Time to get back to nature, using natural products, eating whole foods, natural foods, lots of green leafy vegetables, getting outside as much as possible. This will definitely help ground you. Connecting with the fairy world. You may be an activist of some kind, or you have something here that you are being asked to contribute in order to make the world a better place. As cheesy as that may sound, I feel like, Taurus, you do have a very important role to play here. Okay, we have Ghosts of the Past. The past returns for a time. So I believe we're in the shadow of that demonic Capricorn, Mercury in Capricorn retrograde. You could still have people. I'm seeing one particular person here that is coming back into your life. However, in this card, in this depiction, she's taken her mask off. Okay, so I feel like this is someone that is coming back to show you, or to like, who they really are, or I actually don't get a negative vibe off of that energy. This could be someone that's just come back to spend some time with you, or they came back. They're coming back into your life for a very specific reason. We have two little witches under the deck. Magical space clearing time. Your friend could be a witch. You and your friend could be witches. I'm also getting something about Gemini. Okay. You two will be like helping each other in some way. I get this as a close friend, a close friendship. Okay. This could actually be someone that you share a spiritual practice with. All right. So let's go ahead and jump into the tarot card portion. Let's see. What is happening for Taurus? Yeah, I was going to say Gemini. So I do feel like you could be dealing with a Gemini here. Who else got this card? I forget one of the earlier signs I read for. Go back in the list and see, but all right. Tell me, what is happening for Taurus over the next 72 hours, spirit? What can they expect? The sun, happiness, a solution to all your problems. Really good things, really good things. Getting outdoors, getting some sunshine. The magician, something that you're manifesting. You're in high manifestation mode. Okay, some of you could be a ma magician here, magicians. As above, so below. So two major arcana right off the bat, two very good major arcana. So I feel like you're manifesting something here that's going to bring you a lot of happiness and success. We have the Wheel of Fortune. Wow. You're manifesting something that's going to, your manifestation is coming. Yeah. The Wheel of Fortune, growth, expansion, and change. Big changes are at play here. Great fortune. Okay. You're manifesting great fortune for yourself and you're going with the flow. Seven of Pentacles. You're starting to see a return on your investment. However, this investment isn't ready to be harvested yet. You still have some ways to go, but the seeds that you planted last season are starting to bear fruit. So they're saying continue to do what you're doing. It looks really good. Let's go ahead and start clarifying these cards. What's the sun? Why is the sun here for Taurus? The Six of Cups. Okay, this is the ghost of the past. I feel the past returns for a time. Yeah, but I feel like this is positive though. I feel like you are enjoying, maybe this could be like childhood memories, a childhood place. There's something innocent, there's something tender, there's something sweet. This could be a childhood sweetheart or a friend from the past. I just get something really lovely from this energy. Why is the magician here? The Six of Swords. This has to do with your healing, your guides, and moving on here, moving, finding calmness and peace. I'm also getting alchemy here or the study of magic. You're studying magic or you're studying something like a magician would, a science book. So you are involved in what do you call it? Alchemy. No. I can't think of the word right now, but occult studies basically is what I want to say. Occult sciences. Why is the Wheel of Fortune here? Some of which is magic that you're doing, but this is healing. I feel like if, you know, there's good witches and bad witches, I would consider you to be a good witch. So nice to meet your acquaintance. We have the Ten of Swords here with the Wheel of Fortune. Unfortunately, I do, fortunately or unfortunately, I do see a painful ending coming up here. Now, this could be for someone else that you're dealing with. Unfortunately, something is going to end abruptly. We'll have to go in and clarify that. Why is the Seven of Pentacles here? The Queen of Cups. There's a water sign here, a Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces. I do pick up Scorpio, and this person is waiting for results on something here. This could be a mother, a psychic, or an intuitive. Very patient person. So this could be your friend here, or of course this could be your mother or someone else. I do get a water sign. Let's go over everything one more time. The sun and the Six of Cups, spirit. What's the sun and the Six of Cups? Tarot familiars. Okay. You could be dealing with a Leo, a fire sign, a Leo, Aries, or a Sagittarius. I pick up Leo's energy here, but also this is a tarot reader. So you could be the tarot reader or you're dealing with one. This is someone from the past that you have fond memories with. Also, someone's doing candle magic here. I don't know. I think you like this person. They like you too. Why is the magician and the Six of Swords here? Why is the Magician and the Six of Swords here? The Queen of Wands. Okay. Yeah, you're doing magic. You are a manager here. You're creative. You could be in a creative field. I see someone that does alchemy arts. Okay. Very beautiful as well. You have a stage presence. Yeah, I feel like also, I don't normally give advice like this in these readings. Of course, I do like to give advice. I have a Virgo moon. But yeah, I would say that the more you can promote your, like, you have a beautiful face or figure, you could use this more in your work somehow. I don't know. It's up to you. But I do see someone here that can definitely, like, you could, yeah, I don't say, I'm not going to say like modeling, but you could use your face in your work a lot, like presenting yourself. Very nicely done here. Someone does their own makeup, etc. Why is Wheel of Fortune, Ten of Swords here? Why is Wheel of Fortune, Ten of Swords here? King of Pentacles. Something is ending with this King of Pentacles pretty abruptly. A Virgo, Taurus, or Capricorn. That would be your energy. I'm not sure what this is. I just feel like it's got something naturally has to end. I don't know why it has to end with the Ten of Swords, though. That's like something being cut off. That's like someone hanging up. That's like someone stabbing someone in the back, really. I'm sorry to see that. But the Wheel of Fortune is karma. What goes around comes around. Why is the Seven of Pentacles? I'm not saying that you deserve this. This could be happening to someone else, of course, but there could be a Taurus out there that is going to experience a painful ending. But the King of Pentacles says that you are coming out on top of this, because the King of Pentacles is the most wealthy one, is the most prosperous one. Yeah, you've secured your fortune at least. Why is the Seven of Pentacles and the Queen of Cups here? Seven of Pentacles, Queen of Cups, Nine of Wands. Well, someone is quite, I heard, tired of something, or feels like they've been through something so many times. Really, really hurt by someone. This Queen of Cups is quite hurt by something. They've been waiting for results on something, and they are getting frustrated. Tell me more about this Queen of Cups and the Nine of Wands. Okay, so something is ending with a water sign. This could be this person from the past here. I don't know this person's relationship to you. I'm guessing that this could be your, I won't say partner. It's not a match, King of Pentacles and the Queen of Cups, but this could be someone's partner here, unfortunately. Why is Ten of Swords, King of Pentacles here? Why is Ten of Swords, Five of Pentacles? Something is not enough for you. Maybe you feel like your needs are not being met to some degree, or you're out in the cold, or it's been a lot of radio silence. Maybe you thought this was over. This could just be a miscommunication, of course, but my question is, why would the Queen of Cups come up with the Nine of Wands? This is definitely someone you have history with. This feeling of lack, loneliness, isolation, or feeling out in the cold is meant to take place because a natural cycle is coming to an end. So if this person is left waiting for results and they're feeling hurt about it, They will figure out eventually that this is over, and it has. I feel like this is someone you've already like communicated with before. I'm not sure why they're coming up in your energy again. I'm getting a little bit frustrated actually because I feel like you did communicate with this person. They just didn't. I don't know, maybe they're slow. Why is the Six of Swords and the Queen of Wands here? Five of Swords. Okay. Yeah. You already let this person know, like, hey, like, jerk, hey, buddy, or hey, lady, like, this is not cool with me. And unfortunately, you did have to get a little bit fierce with them. You did have to kind of draw a line in the sand. So, why is the Sun and the Six of Cups and the Tarot Familiars card here? The Moon. Well, initially, when this person comes back into your life, it'll seem like they're being honest with you and that everything's great. But they are hiding something here. They are. There's something that they're not telling you, or there's something that's being hidden from you. I wonder who this could be, because I have a fire sign here, an earth sign, and a water sign. I also said I saw Gemini at the beginning, but that may or not be the case. Ace of Wands underneath the deck. Judgment. Yeah. Someone's getting karma here. Death, Scorpio's energy, something's over. Look, there's a high priestess involved. This could even be a coven of some kind. Someone's looking into a high priestess here. Something is over. Someone's calling judgment and the Ace of Wands. Someone may be doing magic. Okay. So, Taurus, this is what I have for you. I hope this reading helped. Thank you for tuning in. Personal reading information is down below and up in the right-hand corner. Have a great 72 hours, everyone. I will see you guys back soon. Take care. Bye.